Hey, guess what I got? I got myself a brand new, what do you call it, lapel mic. So now I can do voiceover, so you don't have to hear my washer, my dishwasher, the dryer, the tea kettle, whatever, Petey, psycho Petey. All right, this is my Whirly Pop, and I'm going to make some popcorn in it. What I have in that quarter cup measure is coconut oil that's got beta carotene in it, and that is movie theater coconut oil. So it's expeller, and all I do is put the pot on medium, and try to get it to melt in my freezing cold kitchen. So in the pot, I'm using 3/4 cup of glaze and 3/4 cup of popcorn. What glaze? This makes a movie theater type caramel corn. No butter, just whatever's in the coconut. So the oil melts, add my popcorn, stir it around a little bit to get the kernels all coated, and then I add an equal amount of glaze. That's 3/4 cup. Yeah, you put it on while you're cooking the stuff, so go ahead and measure that out. So that's 1/4 cup of coconut oil, 3/4 cup of Orville, I think we're using today, and 3/4 cup of the glaze pop. And we got that on Amazon. Hungry thought it would be a good idea. So now with the Whirly Pop and the glaze and whatever, keep that handle turning. You don't want to pause and, you know, answer the phone or anything. This stuff will catch fire. It will burn very easily. When we got it, the whole house smelled like it. Wasn't even open. Still in the Amazon package. So Hungry put it into a big baggie, a gallon Ziploc, and stuck it in the pantry. The whole pantry smells like this glaze. I mean, it's a nice smell, but after 3-4 days of it, you don't like it anymore. Okay, so now we're stirring so nothing burns and popcorn won't stick to the bottom. Hopefully. So keep turning it and turning it, and you'll hear the kernels start to pop. And you're just looking because it hasn't started popping. And then, if the popcorn maker gets a little bit stiff to handle, lift it up off of the burner and don't worry about turning the handle because you don't want to break it. So you give it a shake, just like you do old-fashioned pot of popcorn. Get a towel, oven mitt, a washcloth, a something to put over your hands because you may get a little bit of splattering, and who wants molten lava on the back of their hand? So keep turning it, keep turning it, keep turning it. And when it stops popping, how do you tell when it stops popping? You get a big long space between the last couple of pops, and you can say 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, or hippopotamus if you're so inclined. I'm speeding it up because it's boring. Okay, so I've got it where it's just about too stiff to turn the handle, and I'm going to try to protect myself. Okay. Yeah, it won't turn now, so here we go. I got my 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, dumped it in a bowl, pulled out the burnt stuff because that's for me, and now we can go ahead and have our movie night. Hungry says he would not buy this again. Why not? Because it's the way it smells. It smells great, but who wants to smell it every day of their lives? So that container will make maybe 4 or 5 batches of popcorn. So I would suggest make it all at once, have a party, eat popcorn, and don't buy it again. Really, it is pretty awful. Okay, so just break up the clumps and go have your movie night. What are we watching tonight? I think Capricorn 1.